With the PeopleSoft Activity Guide Composer, your functional administrator can easily configure Activity Guide templates, which are guided procedures that your users complete. Activity Guides are easily included in onboarding and offboarding processes and life events. They also work in job change processes like leaves of absence or promotions, and processes with checklists, as you'd find in payroll or time and labor. The PeopleSoft Activity Guide Composer separates the technical tasks from the functional tasks when setting up an activity guide and provides a step-by-step process guide for your administrator. Let's start by reviewing an onboarding activity guide template in the Activity Guide Composer. You can change the delivered PeopleSoft templates by inserting a new effective dated row or cloning the template. For today, we'll insert a new effective dated row and then update the template. The Activity Guide Composer guides you through setting up a new template or modifying an existing template. You must select an activity guide type. Use the View Example button to see a sample layout. Depending on the type of activity guide you selected, you may have to choose additional options, such as autosave and display side panel. The General Information tab shows you a description of the activity guide and the activity guide category. The activity guide category determines the options shown for actions, images, and steps in the template. The next step, security, defines the roles for the administrators and end users. You can add multiple administrator and end user roles. The Additional Actions step lists the actions you can specify for a template. The Activity Guide category associated with the template determines the available actions. Next, you can configure the sub-banner for your activity guide. The sub-banner can display an image and up to 3 fields of additional information. You can see examples of each sub-banner type. Next, select the steps to include in the template. The activity guide category assigned to the template determines the steps shown. You can add a step more than once. For example, you can add multiple attachment steps in multiple places in the onboarding process. Use the Organize and Configure Steps page to put the steps of your activity guide in order. You can set the attributes for a step, like assigning the start and due date and specifying whether a step is required. In addition, you can define a simple yes or no question that determines if a user wants to perform a step. Your users see the questions in a questionnaire before starting the activity guide. Their answers determine which steps they see. You can also configure dependencies and page text from here. The Display and Processing step allows you to decide whether to display the new activity guide in My Activity Guides. You can make the template active or inactive with the Review and Activate step. Now let's take a look at some of the technical setup needed. Start by navigating to the Categories page. The Activity Guide category includes technical information that supports the configuration of a PeopleTools Activity Guide template. Categories help you separate the types of activity guides your organization needs. In addition, the Activity Guide category controls context. Context lets you specify the fields that create a unique instance of an activity guide. In this example, the Onboarding Activity Guide category is job-specific and requires the employment record, operator ID, and the employee ID as context. Other information can come from contextual data like job code descriptions and hire date. Remember that the category determines the actions, images, and steps available for templates. When we set up the template for an activity guide, you saw how the actions, images, and steps are used in the template. The available actions, images, and steps that you could add to the template came from the onboarding category. Activity Guide Composer also provides other utilities that help you to set up activity guide templates. Template Assignment is a utility that specifies how to assign the templates. For example, you can assign onboarding templates based on a new employee's business unit. In our example, the system should assign employees in the CAN01 business unit to the Onboarding for Canada template, not the standard template. You can test your template assignment criteria using the Test Template Assignment utility. enter the test values for the criteria, and then select the Assign Template button to see which template the system assigns. The My Activity Guides page displays all the activity guides for an end user. From here, you can start an activity guide, continue a partially completed guide, or delete an activity guide altogether. This is useful if you're building activity guides for administrators. You can access activity guides from a centralized location without building custom pages or tiles to start each activity guide. For example, as an administrator, you can start an activity guide from here. This is an example of the questionnaire configured in the template. Your answers to the questions determine which steps you see. Then, you get into the actual steps of the activity guide. The PeopleSoft Activity Guide Composer enables your functional administrators to set up and manage their own templates with guided steps, easy-to-understand instructions, and clear examples. Guiding your users through processes using activity guides goes from being a good idea to becoming a reality. For more information, go to peoplesoftinfo.com.